I welcome you all with my love and respect. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, shrimahans, mahans, tanidar kotaris, sarvanya pitakartas, yajamans, manifestors, sarvabarityahis, kailasas, ministers, ambassadors, diplomats, e-diplomats, citizens, consulate generals, and supporters. Mantreshwaras, Vidyeshwaras, Ganeshwaras, Lokeshwaras, and Astreshwaras. Paramashiva Ganas. Season 11, participants. I welcome all of you with my love and respect. Paramashiva's message. Directly from Kailas. Thirty-six principles of my own manifestation, learning by which you will intensely manifest multiple powers for which you are hardwired, and glorify your existence as Paramashiva. Manifest your Paramashivatva and reach Paramashiva Gadi. I'll expand now. 36 principles. Yesterday when I was explaining about the time-space continuum, I introduced briefly these 36 principles. The most beautiful thing about Hinduism is everything is explained only to make you enlightened. Moksha-centric knowledge. Moksha-centric knowledge. All my kids, listen. This is specially for Gurukul kids, listen. Do not learn anything which is not directly making you manifest powers and moksha. See, Paramashiva manifesting through your body is Paramashivatva. You merging into him is Paramashiva Gadi. Either you should be manifesting Paramashivatva or you should be merging in Paramashiva Gadi. To all my kids, I want to tell this. Do not learn anything which is not moksha-centric. Paramashivatva or Paramashiva Gadi centric. And I tell you one small incident. My guru, Yogananda Puri, he used to tell me, don't eat in the night time. Once sun sets, don't eat. And after sunset, if you feel the hunger, it is false hunger. In Tamil, you will tell very cutely, hey, payiru poi sollumada. Adukkellam choru podapadadu. Thuniya thannila pusakki potu paduthukanum. Eera thuni, eera kola mela potu thoongiranum. I'll translate in English. My guru used to tell, after sunset, if your stomach says you are feeling hungry, the hunger signal, he says it's a false hunger. Don't give food. Take a wet cloth, cold wet cloth, in water, cloth dipped in cold water. Put it on your stomach. It should touch your liver. That whole area should be covered. And sleep off. In Indian villages, it is always used as a definition of poverty. I don't even have the money for food. So we used to put the wet cloth on our stomach and sleep. Hey, it is not symbol of poverty anymore. It's a symbol of richness now. Third rate, poor, lower middle class people live like a pig, eating three times. Rich royal kings eat once in a month. Stop eating after sunset. Don't associate food and richness. After sunset, if you are feeling hungry, your stomach is lying to you. It is false hunger. Just put a wet cloth on your stomach, covering up to liver area, and sleep. Only first few days you may struggle a little bit, but do this for health. Actually, one person asked my guru, I saw this very conversation, he asked my guru, will I not get gastric problem if I don't eat when I am feeling hungry? He said, gastric problem won't kill you, but if you eat after sunset, you will get liver problem and die. I tell you, after sunset, your body has enough fire, fuel, only to burn what is already consumed. See, in digestive fires, there are three level digestive fires. Jataragni has three form of existence. So understand, after sunset, your Jataragni is alive only to burn what is already taken into the body. It does not have the energy needed to receive more load. All great enlightenment-centric lifestyle jatis among the Brahmanas, the Agnihotri, the highest Brahmanas, and Bharatvaja Gotri, the most pure flying Brahmanas, understand? The Bharatvaja Gotra Brahmanas used to fly. Bharatvaja is the rishi who wrote the whole science of flying, and Bharatvaja Gotra Brahmanas had the DNA, they used to move from place to place, akasa marga. Our Hindu way of flying was collective, means like a group, as The whole group, you can get into a flight and fly. That kind of flying machines were also available. As an individual, you can just fly, having a small attachment to your body, like a wing. Hindus had both technology. Individually, you can fly, and you can go with a group or a team, both. Mechanism we had. Bharadwaja Gotri, Gotra Brahmanas, used to have this flying signs as their regular lifestyle. All these, the highest level among the Saiva Velalar, Adisaiva Velalargal, Adisaiva Velalas, and among the Jains, the top cream community. All these communities don't eat after sunset. They don't eat after sunset. Not eating after sunset is one of the most intelligence kindling technique. Hey, listen. Listen to what I am saying. Every day, night, it's not that you fall into the same dream state or deep sleep state. Depending on the chemistry of your body that day, the state in which you are going to settle down will be decided. If there is so much of food toxins in your body, naturally, you will fall into the shit state. If you have done Nirahara Samyama, you will understand. Even your sleep will be so beautiful. It will be just a beautiful, romantic, light space. Why you like romance so much? You know, it makes you light. It gives you a Jagrat Sushupti state experience, the lightness of Sushupti and alive feeling of Jagrat. If you stop eating after sunset, your body goes through a beautiful detox process and self-cleansing. I guarantee within 11 days, your whole sleep, dream, the whole night, that state will become beautiful, romance kind of a space. Just do these two, three things. Stop eating after sunset. From morning till night, whatever you do, do it to your Atmalinga. You will simply see in the night, you are just cuddling Paramashiva and sleeping. You are just sleeping in the lap of Paramashiva. You will be in that space. You are sleeping in the lap of Paramashiva. Listen. Less food or no food in the stomach during night keeps your whole state of consciousness pure. Actually, half an hour of Turiya state or that sweet romance space rejuvenates your body and mind more than 10 hours of sleep and dream state. The quantity of your sleep will drastically reduce. The time you are rolling on the bed will drastically reduce. and the quality of your restful rejuvenated feeling will drastically increase. Understand? My whole life is focused on raising the quality of your consciousness. Last 26 years, after my gurus ordained me, gave me the pita, the inheritance, the only work I am doing, only thing I am focused on is raising the quality of your existence. Listen, keep the stomach empty in the night time. You can have cold wet cloth on the stomach covering up to the liver area. Even the ice bag is great to have. The ice pack or ice bag is great to have. It will lead to raise in the quality of your consciousness. Very natural, smooth way, your whole sleep time will be converted into meditation time and turiya state. Understand? The stomach filled with undigested food, shit, heat, like an industry, if it is running, it will ruin your rest, rejuvenation. If it is clean, pure fire, the Jataragni is not loaded, very pure, beautiful, like a lamp in the Garbha Mandir of a temple. The whole fire will reach the crown center. You will reach Turiya. And Turiyatita state, highest conscious existence. I guarantee anyone who doesn't eat after sunset lives healthy, rich, long life, because wealth is nothing but smart strategy to be useful to others and make the world useful to you. That all is wealth. That develops in your system. Even if you enjoy Turiya, Turiyatita state, few minutes a day, and with this no food in the stomach after sunset, automatically you will fall into Turiya and Turiyatita. I am telling you, in Hindu tradition, any tattva we explain only for liberation. Moksha-centric lifestyle. moksha centric knowledge. All the best, healthy, rich, long, healthy living communities, Bharatvaja Gotra Brahmanas, practicing Iyengars, Adishaiva Velalar, Jain. In Jain community, there is a community, very top cream of the Jain society, which practices the Salekana and no eating after sunset. All this community, if you see, they don't eat after sunset. My grandmother used to say, only ghosts will eat after sunset. Ratirla pey danda thingum, ratirla thinna pey aiduvumda. Means only ghosts will eat after sunset. And if you eat after sunset, you will become ghost. Don't. You can become intensely active, alive, rich, healthy, living long life. If you just take up this simple principle, and it is not that you need to struggle with these principles forever, no. Just first few days only practice. Once your body starts tasting this lifestyle, even you will not be able to spoil yourself. Even you will not be able to destroy yourself. That is the beauty of this great science. That is the beauty of this great science. Especially now, this pandemic fatigue, I am seeing clearly, whole world is going through that delusional arrogance. Means everybody is ready to die but don't want to have any more restrictions or quarantine principles. People are sick and tired of all the quarantine principles, travel restrictions, everything. They are now ready to die. It's not that corona numbers have come down, infection or death numbers have not come down, but all the restrictions are relaxed because people have decided it's okay to die. But doesn't want to. Restrict themselves. This is what I call pandemic fatigue, delusional arrogance. Unfortunately, politics got mixed into Corona now. All right. Let's keep science out of politics and let's keep pure spiritual truths as it is. Anyhow, all my followers, listen. Stay home, stay safe, at least till December 14th. Let this pralaya be over. Let this pralaya be over. Let me come back to the today's message. 36 tattvas. See, the 36 tattvas can be explained from various angles, from the angle of physics, chemistry, biology, alchemy, from various angles it can be explained. I am going to explain from the angle of enlightenment, Paramashivatva and Paramashiva Gadi. Understand? Paramashivatva means Paramashiva manifesting in you. Paramashiva Gadi means you resting in Paramashiva. You becoming one with Paramashiva. This word is Shiva Gadi. It's earliest recorded by Tirumular. Siva Siva Enridat Shiva Gadi Dhani. சிவசிவ என்கிற தீவினை ஆளர் சிவசிவ என்றிட தீவினை மாளும் சிவசிவ என்றிட தேவரும் ஆவர் சிவசிவ என்றிட சிவகதிதானே மீன்ஸ் பீப்புள் ஹூ டோன்ட் நோ த வைப்ரேஷன் மகாசப்த சிவ சிவ ஃபால் இன்டு த நெகட்டிவ் கர்மா லைஃப் நெகட்டிவ் Who knows this Mahashabda Shiva, Shiva, Shiva will reach the space of Devas. All their life negativity will be destroyed. And ultimately, they will have the Shiva Gadi. Understand. Detoxing your consciousness supporting your consciousness for it to manifest in your body. Is the purpose of my life. I am going to explain these 36 principles from the angle of enlightenment, helping you to manifest Shiva Gadi. Before starting, the deeper levels of explanation, I want all of you to sit straight. If you want, drink water, have a cup of coffee, hot chocolate, cup of tea, anything is okay. Keep your Atmalinga next to you. If you have Jnananjana, Atmalinga, keep all of it next to you. Sit. So every principle, when I am explaining, it just directly gets into your system and starts operating. Right. Keep all of it next to you for a few minutes. Shiva, 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 Shiva. Shiva, 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 Shiva. Shiva, 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 Shiva. Shiva, 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 Shiva. Shiva, 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 Shiva. Shiva, 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 Shiva. Shiva, 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 Shiva. Shiva, 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 Shiva. Shiva, 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 Shiva,
Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva.
You can open your eyes and please listen. Akshupta Bindu, the pure Paramashiva's space. I bow down to Paramashiva Ganapati. I bow down to Paramashiva. Let Paramashiva's akshupta bindu state manifest in all of us and make us all realize this 36 tattvas from the shiva gadi. Understand? I am going to explain these 36 tattvas. For enlightenment, to manifest Paramashivatva and Paramashiva Gadi, and with the realization of establishing Paratva. The supremacy or the ultimate state of Paramashiva. Paramashiva Paratattvattai Unarndu, realizing the supremacy of Paramashiva over this whole existence. I am explaining Paramashiva Paramashiva's view of these 36 principles for all of us to manifest Paramashivatva and Paramashiva Gadi. Paramashiva Padam. Listen. The first and foremost requirement for this Akshup the bindu state is dhiraha, do not stop anywhere in between when you are given wealth, luxury, longevity or all the pleasures till you reach the Paramashiva state. See, one of the biggest problem you will have when you start manifesting powers is not having what you want. You will be having too much of what you want and you may start getting stuck with the psychodrama of wanting and having and wanting and having and wanting and having and forget the Paramashiva. Listen carefully. Poverty will not be your bigger problem. Too much of wealth will be your bigger problem. Poverty will not be your problem. Too much of luxury will be your real problem. Decide you will be dhira. You will not stop anywhere by becoming Deva or Devendra or any of the other higher states. You will have the guts, courage, not to stop till you manifest Paramashiva. Understand? Take the Sankalpa and request Paramashiva to support you in this Sankalpa. You should manifest Paramashivatva. Till then, you should not stop. I am not saying don't enjoy the luxuries of Devaloka or luxuries of Bhuloka. I am not saying don't en- I am not at all saying don't enjoy. I am not saying stop enjoying. No. I am not saying don't have the luxuries of this loka, this world or Devaloka. No. I am only saying don't stop there. Don't be stuck there. Okay. I have a big couch. So I will rest when I want. But I am not going to put the seat belt on couch just because I bought it for $2,000 and spend whole day on that couch and become stupid potato couch or couch potato. No. Whenever you are stuck with your luxuries, your luxuries become more valuable than your consciousness. I am only saying, stop getting stuck. Understand? Stop getting stuck. Actually, I want to select and elect Kailasa administration and people for Hindu parliament. Before that, I wanted to define these 36 principles. Only people who understand these 36 principles, I want them to be part of the Kailasa administration and Hindu parliament. That is why I am expanding on these principles and these concepts. Do not be stuck in any luxury. Let your luxuries not make you forget your Akshupta Bindu state, Paramashivatva, Paramashivagadi. పరమశివ పరతత్వ నిరూపణం. ఐ వాంట్ టు ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ ద సుప్రీమసీ ఆఫ్ పరమశివ, అల్టిమేట్నెస్ ఆఫ్ పరమశివ. సో యూ విల్ నాట్ గెట్ స్టక్ ఇన్ ఎనీ అదర్ లగ్జురీ, కంఫర్ట్, fulfillment or anything else. Few days before in the satsang I was telling, wherever I obeyed my gurus 100%, I got untold benefits, not only known, many unknown benefits. Wherever I did not listen to my guru's words absolutely, not only I had direct repercussions and untold other problems. So understand, take this sankalpa of being a dhira. Dhira means courageous, bold, ferocious, powerful, will not stop anywhere in between till I manifest Paramashivatva and Paramashivagadi, Paramashiva Padam. Take this sankalpa. Even if Intraloka is offered to you, even if you are made as king of heaven, don't be stuck there. Tell them very clearly, thanks for your offer, but I want only to be Paramashiva. That is the purpose of Paramashiva Paratva Nirupanam. There is a beautiful verse in Vaishnavi tradition. Pachaima Malaybol Meni Pavalavai Kamalachengan Achyuta Amarar Ere Ayardam Kolundi Ennum Ichuvai Tavira Yanboy Indira Logamalum Logamalum Achyuvai Perinum Vendain Arangama Nagarulane. Devotee of Vishnu cries to Vishnu, the taste of me celebrating you, singing the glory, Pachaima Malaybol Meni Pavalavai Kamalachengan Achyuta Amarar Ere Ayardam Gulakkolunde. The taste of singing, the feeling, connection, oneness with you is the best. Even if I am made as the head of the Indraloka, as a ruler of the Indraloka, I do not want that. I only want the feeling connection with you. I'll say that is the dhira of a bhakta. A devotee's dhira. Same way, all of you should have the dhira. Paramashivatva, Paramashiva Gadi, Paramashiva Pada is the only goal. Till then, you can enjoy whatever comes in the way, nothing wrong. Don't be stuck. You can sit in the couch, but don't put seat belt. You can enjoy, but don't get stuck. Have your beautiful purity. In villages, when they cut the jackfruit, they will apply castor oil on the hand so that the gum in the jackfruit will not get stuck in the hand and make the hand messy. I tell you, pour castor oil every day inside your system. The patterns and biomemories, negative biomemories, will not get stuck in your internal organs. It may look very funny. Do it, then you will understand. Bhakyamam abhijanati yavan yaschasmi tatvatah tatomam tatvado jnatva visade tadanantaram. Gita 18th chapter 55th sloka. By devotion he knows me in reality, what and who I am. Then having known me in reality, he forthwith enters into the Supreme. You should know Paramashivatva, Paramashiva Gadi, Paramashiva Padam is your only goal. Everything else is okay on the way. to enjoy, but not to get stuck. I want all of you to understand, anyone who decides with dhira, the akshupta bindu state, the pure paramashiva state, starts immediately blessing you, supporting you, guiding you, and starts manifesting itself in you. Listen. When you decide with dhira, O Mahadeva, Paramashiva, I belong to you. I want only you to manifest in me. Let me not get stuck with anything else. When you decide this with dhira, this very sankalpa, Paramashiva starts blessing you. Yes, I. Listen, the moment you apply for visa to Paramashiva, for Kailasa, immediately he starts looking at you, not just issuing visa, how he can get you to Kailasa and make you as a Kailasa citizen, train you and evolve you next, and ultimately becoming, merging him into you, you into him. You plan for Kailasa visa, he plans for making you Paramashiva. You look him for visa, he looks you as Shiva. Listen. Listen carefully. This initiation I am going to shower on all of you will be so intense, so energetic, so alive, manifesting powers, joy, ecstasy. Poverty will not be your problem. Rather, luxury will be your problem. Disease will not be your problem. Rather, hyperactive energy will be your problem. Don't stop till you reach Paramashivatva. I have a Shastra Pramana collected from Shushruta Samhita, 64th chapter, 85th sloka. Sayam prata manushyanam asanam shridishoditam nantara bhojanam kuryat agnihotra samo vidihi. Human beings should eat only in the morning and in the evening as per the Vedic injunction. Food should not be eaten in between these two meal times. This rule is equal to the rule of agnihotra vidhi. Not to eat after sunset. Not to eat before sunrise. This is the beautiful Shastra Pramana from Shushruta Samhita, I want all my disciples to follow this. See, if you have become recently my disciple, my devotee, and having a pot belly is tolerable. If you are my disciple, my devotee, more than 1 year, and still you have a pot belly, I feel something is seriously wrong. You are not following my words. You are cheating yourself. So understand. Thou shall not have pot belly. Don't try to say, oh, Ganapati also have a pot belly. Hey, Ganapati has a whole Brahmanda in his belly. But you are having all the shit in your belly. Don't compare your belly and Ganesha's belly and try to justify. Thou shall enter the kingdom of Kailasa only without pot belly. Thou shall not be allowed into the kingdom of Kailasa with pot belly. I made the entrance of Kailasa in such way that pot belly people will be stuck. This is something very serious. Being slim, trim, healthy is the basic qualification of Nityananda's disciple. Being devotee or disciple of Nityananda, the basic qualification is slim, trim, healthy. If you are new, okay, tolerable, but not more than 1 year. You are my disciple, my follower for 1 year, you should be slim, trim, healthy. So let me explain this dhira, because only if I make you dhira, all my 36 principal definitions will be useful for you. Otherwise, it is just useless. What is the use? There is a beautiful Thirumandiram. Sivagadiye gadi matrulla ellam bavagadi paasa piraviyonrundu tavagadi tannodu nerondru thondril அவகதி மூவரும் அவ்வகையாமே. லெட் மீ ரிப்பீட், இட்ஸ் சோ டேஸ்டி. த பவர்ஃபுல் காக்னிஷன்ஸ் ஈவன் டு சாண்ட் இட் டேஸ் சோ ஸ்வீட் இன் யுவர் டங். சிவகதி ஏகதி மற்றுள்ள எல்லாம் பவகதி பாச பிறவியொன்றுண்டு தவகதி தன்னொடு நேரொன்று தோன்றில் அவகதி மூவரும் அவ்வகையாமே. சிவகதி அலோன் இஸ் எட்டர்னல் லிபரேஷன். சிவகதி அலோன் இஸ் த அல்டிமேட் ரியாலிட்டி. ஆல் அதர் ஸ்டேட்ஸ் கதீஸ் will lead only to cycle of birth and death. Bondage comes back to you. Anything else other than Shivagadi should not be allowed. Your penance, tapasya, punya, with all that, choose only Shivagadi, not anything else. Anything else will lead to three malas, impurities, unbondage, birth and death cycle, delusion. Fundamental qualification for anyone to be part of Kailasa is definite dhiratva. Dhira means being ferocious with yourself. I will achieve only Shivagadi. Anything which comes on the way is okay, but I will not be stuck with it or stop with it. I will not be consciously deciding to cherish, entertain, engage or be with those intermediary states, spaces, poses, luxuries, comforts. Shiva Gadi is the Gadi. Shiva Padam, Shiva Gadi, Shivatvam, Parama Shivatva, Parama Shiva Gadi, Parama Shiva Padam. Actually, with this Paramashiva Padam, Paramashiva Gadi, Paramashivatva, keeping this as a goal with a dhiratva, with a ferociousness and courage, if you start understanding these 36 tattvas, you will manifest powers immediately. That is why Patanjali teaches Samadhi Pada first, then he teaches all the other padas. So I'll continue to expand on 36 tattvas, a clear, crisp, sharp definitions in further satsangs. Today I just wanted to prepare all of you about what it is exactly, why I am doing what I am doing. Because only if you understand the ultimateness of Paramashiva and decide to be with that, you can be part of Kailasa administration or Hindu parliament. So first I am doing what needs to be done first. So sit straight. Let's all enter into Paramashivatva. Manifest Paramashiva Gadi. Be in Paramashiva Pata. Om Paramashiva Ganapataye Namaha. Om. Shiva. 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 Mahadeva. Paramashiva. Manifest your Akshupta Bindu state, Nirvigalpa Samadhi in all of us. Let Shiva Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Shakti Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Shada Shiva Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Ishvara Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Shuddha Vidya Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Maya Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Kala Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Niyadi Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Kalakala Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Vidya Tattva manifest in all of us. Let Raga Tattva, Purusha Tattva, Prakriti Tattva, Buddhi Tattva, Manas Tattva, Ahankara Tattva, and Panchanyani Indriyas, Panchakarmi Indriyas, Panchatanmatras, Panchabhutas, all be purified and manifest Paramashivatva, Paramashiva Gadi, Paramashiva Padam. Om. 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 Shiva, 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 Shiva.
Shiva, 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 Shiva Shiva, 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 Shiva. Shiva, 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 Shiva.
I have a beautiful Shastra Pramana to share with you all from Srimad Bhagavatam, 3rd Skanda, 6th Adhyaya, 45th Sloka. Tataparecha Atma Samadhi Yoga Balena Jitva Prakritim Palishtam Tvameva Dhiraha Purusham Visanti. The Dhiras, by their sheer power of Samadhi, always being in oneness with their true self, the pure consciousness, conquer the powerful Prakriti, the whole manifest world, and also their own Antakarana, the inner space, which are influenced by the three gunas, Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, and ultimately indeed enter into you, O Lord. That's a beautiful sloka about the Dhira, the qualities of Dhira. So, with this I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, the state, space, powers, being, superconsciousness of Paramashiva and Kailasa of Paramashiva. Paramashivoham, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. The eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.